Sakura Wars is finally out and I'm losing my mind. This game, this series, means so much to me, and having it finally released in the West 10 years later after the last attempt is a dream come true. It's a game I've been hyping up along with just about every other Sakura Wars fan out there. We're a pretty niche group, but we're strong, and thanks to Sega getting the word out, some heads have been turned and I find myself getting frequent questions. Is this game worth getting if I'm new to the series? This video is meant to try and spread the word, hype up the game, and get folks interested or convinced to give the series a try. The last attempt at bringing Sakura Wars to the West was a failure and nearly sunk the franchise for good. Not that it was the game's fault, though. So Long My Love is an amazing addition to the series, but terrible promotion and release windows basically sunk the ship before it could even leave the port. The game was released in 2005 in Japan, but didn't hit Western shores until 2010, 5 years later. You know what else was happening in 2010? The PS2 and the Wii, the two platforms that So Long My Love released on, were dying. Heck, you could even say that the PS2 was already dead, seeing as the PS3 had been out since 2006 already. Did you hear about Sakura Wars in 2010? I don't even know if there was any promotion. I only found the game by chance, walking into a GameStop, and saw the premium edition box sitting there, top shelf, facing the entrance, as if calling to me. It was fate. But unfortunately, the game fell into obscurity. Sales didn't hit, and we lost a cherished and respected series. Until now. I think there was a poll or something to gauge what beloved franchises fans would like to see Sega bring back, and Sakura Wars was at the top. So they brought it back, and gave the West a close release date too. And here we are. Now, back to the question. Should you get into this new Sakura Wars game if you've never been into the franchise before? I'll give you the short answer here and now. Yes. Look, if you like building bonds with characters through dialogue choices, and if you like plow through a mob Musou style gameplay, that's all you need. You don't even need to have played the previous games beforehand to know what's going on. You might miss references and name drops that might give you extra feels from knowing events in the past games, as they are mentioned, but for the most part, the title stands on its own. Immediate cons being, maybe the adventure mode can get a little long and slow for some folks to want to sit through. The combat is easy, and there's no English dub. Other than that, it's a great game. Is that bias talking? Yes and no. Of course I'm gonna want you to buy a game from a series I love so much, but here's where the long answer comes in. Even putting my bias aside, I have to say I would still recommend this game, and that's mostly due to the changes made to evolve the series and make it a more accessible thing to a modern audience. Each and every change made, I approve of, with the exception of one in particular, which seemed a bit out of character for the franchise, and more of an attempt to grab the approval of the vast amount of people who developed a cheek-touching fetish after Fire Emblem wormed its waifu tendrils into the deepest recesses of their brain. Fire Emblem Awakening, indeed. And though the changes are flawed to be sure, they're perfect for exactly what they set out to do. Upon its first announcement, I wasn't really expecting to recommend the series exactly. It's pretty niche. The originals were more static, so to speak. Adventure mode was done through still images, very much like a visual novel. Combat was grid-based strategy RPGs, though it eventually developed into more of a 3D SRPG akin to that of Valkyria Chronicles. Those two things, well, they're kinda slow-paced. They're not for everybody, and surely not for this modern age where everything needs to be moving at mock speed. Sure, slow and steady is great to folks in theory, but there's few people who actually do stop to smell the roses instead of treating it as a novel concept. So, you play as Seijiro Kamiyama, a former naval captain who has been assigned to the Imperial Combat Review. Their job? Soothe the hearts of the people through song and dance during the day, fight demons at night, romance some waifus on the side. Honestly, Fire Emblem fans should feel right at home with this stuff. Welcome, Three Houses peeps. You're in charge of a ragtag group of girls who are doing their best but just can't seem to get the theater out of the slump it's been in. Because of that, the threat of being closed down looms like a shadow, and on top of that, you got demons. Each girl has their own personality that you're gonna want to play at and get along with in order to build bonds that'll help you get boosts and advantages in fights. Once a demon attacks, you'll hop in your steam-powered kobus, or spherical armors, and keep the city safe. The cutscenes are 3D and fully acted, albeit not fully voiced. It makes for some hilariously exaggerated reactions, and I'm totally here for it. But most of all, it gives way more feeling to what's happening between characters than static images could. And don't get me wrong, I love the anime cutscenes we got in the previous games, but the action cutscenes we've been given in this new title are on a whole other level. Are you freaking seeing this? I mean, Sakura Wars knows how to get you hype with the love and friendship crap and the music swelling and the "your drill is the drill," but coupled with these gorgeous cutscenes just gets me so pumped. I dare you not to smile while playing this game. Combat is now real time, and although fighting is easy and you very rarely even have to worry about running low on health, it's still a lot of fun to play. The button inputs have a quick and immediate reaction. You can zip around and dodge, use light and heavy attacks and combos, use super moves, and it's all flashy as heck. I mean, you feel like a boss. There's even a little simulator that you can mess around in and try to get the best grade with different requirements, which gives a bit more of a challenge outside of the story. I find them very engaging whenever I feel a need to take a quick break from adventure mode. I think the best thing about this game is how well it stays true to what made Sakura Wars so well loved in the first place, while making the new advances work well in tangent, for the most part. Am I saying the game's perfect? No. I'm a bit over halfway done with the game, and I'm already well aware of nitpicks and genuine downsides that would definitely be pointed out in a more in-depth look at the game once I finish it. But I do think it's a shining example of what a reboot of a long-thought dead series should be like. A step in the right direction, opening itself to a wider audience while staying true to itself. The last localization of So Long, My Love was a gamble that was handled poorly and it kicked back hard. Now that Sega has taken all the right steps towards reviving the series, I want to see it flourish. I'd love for folks to give the series a chance. At most you'll love it, and at the very least, I think you'd find an appreciation for it. Feel the genuine love and respect that was poured into the game and that ignites the passion of its fans. So go out there and get the game. Maybe even watch a bit of a beginning of a Let's Play. That can hurt to give you an idea of what you might be getting into. And now that I've talked a little bit about this game trying to hype it up, I'm not quite sure how to end this video. It was just supposed to be a quick hype video of sorts anyway. Something to spread the word, you know? If I can sway even just one person, then I've done my part. Anyway, thanks for taking the time out to watch this video. I really appreciate it. Until next time, guys, stay chill.